You sweating out an ER rotation?
No, I am covering from Steve. Told him to take the rest of the night off.
That was nice of you.
It's the least I could do. The guy deserves 24 hours to grieve over his nephew.
Well, let me take it off your hands.
Really?
Yeah, you look brain fried. Believe it or not, prior that I am, I'd like to help support Elizabeth and Steve in some small way.
Well, I'm not very good at organizing people, so, there you go. I'm not gonna argue.
It's progress. What?
Sometimes I look at you and I see a glimpse of humanity. And I remember everything you've done. Dr. Sam
Nicholson,
please.
Hi.
Hey, I was looking for you.
Yeah, what's up?
What time are you off?
Probably about a half hour.
Do you think we can go to Kelly's for some coffee? I have something I want to run by you.
Yeah, of course. Should I be worried?
No, I mean, I don't think so. It's not anything bad.
You want to give me a hint?
Let's just say I may have a way to cement our reconciliation. You still off to Kelly's?
Absolutely. Anything to work on our relationship.
Remember you said that. I seemed a little pensive when I walked up. Everything okay?
Yeah, I was just thinking about Jake's memorial service. Probably the saddest thing I've ever sat through.
Yeah, it was awful. You could hear the sounds of hearts breaking. I hope you're not blaming yourself in any way.
Well, I'm trying not to. It was a blow to lose Jake on the table, that's for sure. But it's nothing compared to what Elizabeth is going through. And you lose a child, there's like a gaping hole in your life, and I don't know. A future that's supposed to be limitless is gone in a second.
Puts things in perspective, doesn't it?
Our family's lost a lot of time that we're not going to get back. But we're here. We're moving forward. That's the important thing.
Yeah, I'm with you on that.
You know, every morning that I wake up in our house, it feels like a gift or a second chance. And I'm not taking that for granted. I want you to know that.
Well, I'm anxious to hear what you have to say.
You want to order first? I hope they have some fresh decaf.
Oh, no. Decaf. That means you're nervous, which makes me nervous.
I'm sorry. I'm probably making a bigger deal out of this than it actually is. And you know what's crazy is that you are the one that's been suggesting this for a long time. So I would like us to go to marriage counseling.
You would?
Yeah, I found us a therapist.
Wow.
Once more, with enthusiasm.
No, I just, I didn't expect you to say that.
It's okay. And you changed your mind or something, right?
No,
I mean, maybe I jumped the gun. Maybe we need to get used to being together again before we tackle all of our big issues.
No, I think we have a lot to work through. And I think the sooner we do that, the sooner we can get back to just loving each other.
You mean that?
Yeah, of course I mean that. It doesn't mean I'm not terrified that we're gonna walk in there and you're gonna realize I'm a jerk and that our marriage isn't worth saving.
Okay, so I'm the one who's come around to the idea of marriage counseling, but I'm scared too.
I don't think you should be scared. I mean, I'm the one that cheated on you. I'm the one that has to figure out why I was so self-destructive to risk my family by sleeping with a psycho.
Okay, to be fair, you didn't know she was psycho
then.
No,
Robin, don't make excuses for me because I'm not making them for myself. I'm scared. I mean, I don't want to go in there and start stripping away all the layers of my psyche. But if it's going to get us back to a good place, then yeah.
Well, no, I don't want it to be about that. I don't want counseling to be about beating you up. You know, this is our marriage, and we both share responsibility in what went wrong. Believe me, I have some hard truths to face as well. I'm scared that everyone in the room will know that I'm just not enough for you.
If you're looking for some big reveal that you're not enough for me, it's not gonna happen because it's not true. You're more than enough.
But I know myself. I like to think that I am perfect, but I am anything but. You know, I push you away, I mean, so much to the point where I almost set you up to fail. and I shut down so hard and fast, why wouldn't you feel resentful?
Okay, I think we're coming at this a little bit wrong. We can't assume that therapy is going to make our problems bigger or anticipate the worst, or it's going to throw a wrench in our reunion.
That's what I'm worrying about. You know, we were apart for so long. I'm just getting used to having you home.
Look, it would be wonderful if we walked into that room and all our unresolved problems went away. That would be great, but it's not going to happen. We have to work for this.
It's about time.
It is. I think we should look at therapy as a positive thing, an opportunity to make things better.
Sounds like a plan.